health of the person. When they leave this world, they take nothing with them. And the difficulty of death, only the faith that you established upon this earth can intercede for you. The strongest love for anything in creation has to be the love of Sayyidina Muhammad. That the one to accompany you into the grave and into the abodes of difficulty through the holy hadith of Sayyidina Muhammad, you be with whom you love. That in the depth of that hadith and all of its knowledges and realities, and in one of its realities is that who will be your companion in the grave? Not the wealth that you brought, not the family that you have, not the possessions, the degrees, not the colleagues and the friends, none of them can help you when that day comes and you have to enter into that box, into the dirt, and they throw the dirt upon you. And all that difficulty in the process of entering to that dirt, that who can intercede for you? Who can be the companion through your difficulties and your trial and your tribulation? That Allah gives to us that gift. I would not have sent. It starts by a negation that Allah said, I would not have sent this reality. But it's a mercy to mankind that the reality of Sayyidina Muhammad is an immense rahmah, an immense mercy. And only Allah come into our life and the fortunate gift that they have given, that when you attend funerals and you attend moments of difficulty in people's lives, you understand what Allah has given as a gift. To the left of you, to the right of you, they don't have that gift. They weren't given that gift. They don't understand the importance of Sayyidina Muhammad. And if Allah gives to you that gift to understand it, He's given you an immense relief, immense relief. Means that neither fear nor grieve for the station of awliyaullah, those whom they are. Allah loves them, and the secret of why Allah loves them, because they love Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We never met one of them that didn't have that immense love. Allah doesn't love them because He loves them. Allah's love for them is because they have an immense love for Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. And as a result their character is sweet, their akhlaq and the goodness of their character, and that Prophet ﷺ perfumes and fragrances them with what Allah is pleased with. Because you be with whom you love.
Assalamu alaikum. We hope that you're enjoying the video, inshallah. Just a request that you help us continue to make such amazing Islamic content, inshallah. Share this video with your friends and loved ones, subscribe to the channels, and donate. Every bit helps. Jazakallah khair, and we will return to the program.
When you love the one whom Allah loves, He dresses you, He blesses you. He teaches you the good and pushes in your heart abstain from the bad, and beautifies you by just that perfection and that reality. As a result they have a sakinah and a tranquility within the heart. They see the sadness of people and the difficulty of death. And there's no relief for that one. Nothing can help them except this love. This love, if you don't feel it when you're alive, you won't even understand it when you're dead. Unless Allah gives you to the hand of awliyaullah who will come into the grave and sit with you, their soul. But if we didn't reach that level, then what Allah want from us is then accompany them and learn. When you learn and take that teaching with your heart and sincerity, and that I want that love, I want that ishq, and that every time I'm reciting these nasheeds I'm sitting at the grave in the presence of Sayyidina Muhammad. Say, Ya Rasul Kareem, Habib Azim, don't leave me to myself, don't leave me to be in difficulty. With that tranquility in the heart and sincerity, they feel that love, they feel that presence and the immensity of that gift. Who's going to be with them in sickness and difficulty coming? It's all your training, what you trained all your life for. You can scream Allah as much as you want, nothing going to happen. Scream out as much as you want Allah, because Allah is going to ask, how come I don't hear you screaming out about Sayyidina Muhammad? That will be its own test for the servant to understand. Those whom were trained and understood say, Ya Rabbi, there's no way to your door except through the love of Sayyidina Muhammad. That all my life and my living days were in that love. Imagine in your last breath when you're sick on a bed and in difficulty, all you can think of is the presence of Sayyidina Muhammad. Ya Rasul Kareem, ijhalana wa ishfalana, ishfalana, take away a difficulty. And the sweetness of that presence, the fragrance of that presence and the intercession, because once you call upon Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ, what Allah says, I'm with Nabiyeen. But when you don't have the adab to call upon the way Allah wants you to call, Allah say, why are you calling upon me alone? Didn't you learn in your living life you have to be with Nabiyeen, Siddiqeen, Shuhada'i wa Saliheen? Be with them and they should be around you. Because you can see at the grave and the station of death that who that person was. Are they surrounded by Saliheen? Remember, it's like a Kaaba. You can tell the state of death when you see the person, do they have the presence of Nabiyeen? Because if they were ashiqeen, they're continuously calling upon Prophet through their difficulty. That ease this pain of death, this tribulation, bring sakina and peace into the hearts of those whom are around me. Because the suffering of those around you causing a suffering for the one who's dying. When they're ashiqeen, they're in continuous love of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ, Nabiyeen. If they were guided, then all their shaykhs are connected to Siddiqeen. Their connection is with Imam Ali ﷺ, Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq ﷺ, because they're all Ahlul Turuq, Ahlul Haqqaiq. So it means then those Siddiqeens are around that person because of the love of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ, they come to support and to help. All the shuhada of that one in their life will be around them in their grave, also making it to be easy the difficulty and the pains of death. And Saliheen means those whom they kept and ate and drank and prayed with, they should be from amongst the righteous people and their death then surrounded by righteous people. But now you see people just dunya and then more dunya people and more dunya people. And they don't care how they're going to treat the body, they're not connected to any Nabiyeen, they have no idea who are Saliheen or Siddiqeen or Shuhada. And that is a great calamity. And the great gift of faith and the great gift of love and ishq that Allah gives of guidance, it won't be understood until you die. It won't be understood fully until you're about to die. And you can die alone somewhere in the woods, it doesn't matter for Allah, you still be with Nabiyeen. All the ruhani will be with there if you're ashiqeen. Nabiyeen, will be their siddiqeen, will be their shuhada, will be their all saliheen from unseen will be surrounding that servant. That's the immensity of this love and the great gift of this Divinely love. But people are heedless with the attraction to dunya and they don't hold a value for it. So alhamdulillah, if we find ourselves listening to these types of associations, participating in these types of associations, it's an immense gift, an eternal gift. To have that love and to depart this world with that love and with that ishq, we pray that Allah grant us that love. Surround us with the love of Allah, surround us with the love of Nabiyeen, Siddiqeen, Shuhada wa Saliheen, whom Allah says that's the best of company. If your company is like that, you're like a Kaaba and Allah is with you. We pray that Allah dress us and bless us and that to continue to guide us towards this immense love and this immense ishq.
Are you ever searching for what zikr to recite for a particular need? We bring to you the Muhammadan Way app, an all-encompassing Islamic guide, where you can find special du'as and prayers, as well as comprehensive Islamic teachings. Download this powerful app now on iOS and Android.
The flavor of life is find something that you're willing to die for and stand behind that. Don't move from it, don't alter with it, that life has to have a purpose. There's a reason which Allah sent us upon this earth and it's not for a good time. Alhamdulillah that Prophet comes to teach us to die before you die. Well, how can you die if you don't know what you want to die for? That's under your control. When you die is under Allah's control. What you want to die for is under your control. To pray that the understanding enters into the heart to die for Allah and to die for the presence of Sayyidina Muhammad and to live a life that Allah accept us to be in that service and that our head to be at their throne and waiting for their isharat, waiting to have a purpose in our life. When we live a life with that understanding, it's the highest of Divinely coordinates, that Rabbi give my life a purpose. That I want to live and die in your way. And that doesn't mean exploding yourself because you don't harm anyone, but that my life serves a purpose for you. Not that it can improve Allah, but to live a life of khidmat and service. What Allah sends, serve my creation, love my creation, serve them, feed them, teach them, and teach them the highest of my teachings, the love of Sayyidina Muhammad. And every time a difficulty and shaitan comes and every hardship that comes to us to test us and to distract us, why you gotta die for that? And if we don't have that purpose and we don't keep that coordinates, this life is like a tufan, it's like a storm. And if you watch these hurricanes and storms, anything loose, it's gone. if the wind has taken it and it's gone, and most likely it blows around and hurts everybody. Anything not tied down, not having a purpose, not having an understanding and an ending. We don't write the book day to day, but we write the end, the last chapter, let me die in your way, Ya Rabbi. Let me die in your way, in the way of Sayyidina Muhammad and Ashiqeen. Let my feet not to become clever and go in a different direction. And at the end you find out you died for what? For money, for businesses, for bank accounts, all of which somebody else will steal. And it won't even go the direction you wanted it to go. And every family fighting over these things, and that was all the purpose of that life. If we don't keep the coordinates of, no Ya Rabbi, I want to die for you. I want to die for your most beloved, so that I'm in the association of their ishq and their love. And with that ishq and that love, they inspire then a purpose for your life. Let's study, learn these realities. Sit in the association of these praises, and it's so easy for everybody to send a click, share an article. You get the blessings of like the one who wrote the article. Don't write your own and make it all incorrect and you'll be accountable for that. Just sharing that article, sharing these links, sharing this stream, and making that intention, Ya Rabbi, let me to die on your way, let me to die with faith. Be raised in the presence of Sayyidina Muhammad. Then my life had a purpose. We tried our best to serve, to do, to write, to teach, to give good character, everyone in their own capacity. Even just to have good character at the zawiya, at work, wherever you are, and be an ambassador for that love. You take that oath that, Ya Rabbi, I'm going to amitna fi tariqatihim. I want to die on my spiritual path. But any moment death is going to come, when I write that last chapter is the most important chapter. Then you know the whole course of your life. People don't know what they want to do. They don't know what they want to be. They don't know what they want to become. That is the stupidest book on earth. Can you imagine writing a book like that? That you don't even understand what the last chapter is going to be? What are you writing? Have you seen movies like that? You watch a movie, say, like, what the heck is this? It's so badly written, they have to describe their plot as they're talking. But in life, the best are the ones whom write their last chapter. Amitna fi tariqatihim, Ya Rabbi. In my last chapter, I want to die and live in your way for your satisfaction and your pleasure. And that is the love of Sayyidina Muhammad ﷺ. Not to leave that love and think I became clever and those are other groups that don't accept that love and don't accept, then you become Hizb al-Shaytan, and that was the aqeedah of shaitan. And when I write that last chapter, my whole life is to reach that. Because every day I write the last chapter and put it on my mirror, that my life is to live and die in the way of Allah. Nobody's going to take me off that path other than Allah. And every day you have to work towards that chapter. I'm going to pray because I want to reach that chapter. I want to do good because I want to reach that chapter. I want to take care of other people because I want to reach that chapter. I want to attend the associations of that chapter. Associations of dancing and parties is not the last chapter, that's a different. So then the last chapter are those whom are in the halaqas and circles of paradise. Why aren't they sitting in a circle of paradise if they love paradise so much? The only guarantee on this earth from Sayyidina Muhammad was what? They didn't say the masjid is paradise. He said the halaqas of zikr are circles of paradise. So if I want to be from my last chapter, I want to be in your paradise, Ya Rabbi, then all my life is to find those circles and attend. And alhamdulillah, now even easier is virtual. I turn on the live, I close my eyes, I'm in their association. Coming soon are the Oculus, and you can feel the association. You put on your clothes and you'll see all the grand shaykhs in their images. All of their graphics will be put into there so that you can feel it with your being. You fake it until you make it, until they open for your heart to sit in that association all the time. We pray that Allah keep us on our last chapter. Give us a life that makes that last chapter to be very beatific, very fragranted, in which the nafs returns to Allah will ask, are you happy and satisfied? And every response is, Ya Rabbi, I'm very content and satisfied with whatever you've bestowed. Nafs ar-radiyah, the one, the soul that is content and in love with Allah, what Allah has bestowed upon it. Subhan rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun wa bihurmati Muhammadin Mustafa wa bi siri rasulikum Fatiha.
If money could just grow on trees, there would be no need for this message. Since it doesn't, let us show you where your generous donations are going. We film, edit, and produce weekly television shows of Divinely Knowledge throughout Canada and the UK, as well as live stream internationally on Facebook and YouTube. Sheikh Nurjan's ever-growing online presence is the result of continuous financial input, and with your financial assistance and participation, this rapid growth will continue. Our Muhammadan Way app is continuously being upgraded and improved, providing an all-encompassing Islamic guide. In addition to the Muhammadan Way app, nurmuhammad.com is a website of immense knowledge and comprehensive Islamic teachings that is updated daily. Your ongoing support also enables a team of editors to compile books of heavenly wisdom from Sheikh Nurjan's teachings. One of our longest ongoing initiatives has been to provide basic necessities to the most in need worldwide, from feeding people in Vancouver's downtown east side to clothing LA's homeless community and supporting a children's orphanage in Pakistan. Your ongoing donations will help us continue to spread the love and example of the Holy Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him. Become a shareholder in immense blessings. nurmuhammad.com/donate.